Welcome everyone to Kingsfish 3. I'm your host Lostwolfe, and this is episode 10. We're bringing spells. In the last episode, we brewed the language of creature spells, so we can understand that. Now, the next spell that we're going to do is brewing a storm. Now, for those of you following along, we're jumping around a bit. And the reason why we're jumping around a bit is because I need to use some stuff to get to other stuff. In this case, we're going to need the spoon that I'm going to use for another spell, but our spoon is currently full of mud, so we need to get rid of the mud on the spoon. Turn to page L X X X I V. Right. So we're going to brew a storm. Put a cup of ocean water in a bowl. Carefully you pour the cup of ocean water into the mixing bowl. Light a charcoal brazier, making sure there is fresh charcoal in the brazier. There is a small supply here. You light it with the flint. Soon the brazier is hot. Heat the bowl on the brazier. Being cautious not to burn yourself, you gently place the bowl of ocean water on the hot charcoal brazier. You watch as the salt water slowly warms, then begins to steam. You remove it just before it boils. Put a spoon of mud in the bowl. Adding a spoonful of mud to the hot ocean water, you slowly stir the mixture. The mud turns the water a cloudy brown. Add a pinch of toadstool powder. You put just a pinch of the toadstool powder into a bowl of hot brown liquid. Brew a storm recitation, because we now need to recite. Blow into the hot brew. Leaning over the hot brew, you forcefully blow your longest breath of air into the bowl, whirling the brew around and around. And now we recite, elements from the earth and sea combine to set the heavens free. When I stir this magic brew, great God Thor, I call on you. And now that we've got that done, we need to wave the magic wand. You wave the magic wand over the bowl of hot brown liquid. Pour the storm brew into the jar. Waiting until the liquid is cooled, you carefully pour the storm brew into an empty glass jar. So we successfully complete making a storm. Right, so now that we made the storm, let's go ahead and talk about causing a deep sleep. And we're going to go to page XIV. Save. Kazoo. Okay, off we go. Grind the acorns in a mortar. Putting the dried acorns into the stone mortar, use the pestle to grind them into a rough acorn powder. put the acorn powder in a bowl. Turning the heavy stone mortar upside down, you carefully pour the acorn powder into the bowl, then return the mortar to the table. Put the nightshade juice in the bowl. You very carefully pour a cupful of nightshade juice into the clay bowl so as not to spill a single drop. Stir the mixture. There is now an ugly brown mealy liquid mixture in the bowl. Stir the mixture with a spoon. You gently stir the unappetizing liquid. Light a charcoal brazier. It's already burning. Good stuff. Heat the mixture on the brazier. So it's going to boil until the nightshade juice is almost gone. Then you remove the heat. Or remove from the heat. You gingerly place the clay bowl of ugly brown liquid on a charcoal brazier. Soon, the hot brazier brings the mixture to a bubble, then a boil, releasing a bitter-smelling steam. You let it boil until the nightshade juice is nearly gone, then remove it from the brazier. Right, so now we're going to... recite. Spread the mixture on a table. You pour the bowl's contents onto the oaken table, then spread the hot sticky mixture over the tabletop. In a few minutes, it is dried to a very crumbly coarse sleeping powder. And off we go. Acorn powder ground so fine. Nightshade juice like bitter wine. Silently in darkness you creep to bring a soporific sleep. That looks right. Wave wand. You pass the magic wand over the table. Put the sleep powder in the pouch. You untie the small leather pouch, scoop the powder from the table, and place it within. You now have a pouch full of sleep powder. And we successfully complete the spell. And we're going to look up from the table that we're working on. And I'm going to get us to where we need to be for the next bit. Look at the map. And we're going to go there, but we're not going to do anything. So in the next episode, we shall complete all the little bits and pieces that we need to do. Actually, hang on. No, let's not. We'll get us there, but we're not going to do anything. We want our sound back. So what we're going to do next is that web is filled with death, and I'll show you very quick. Well, yeah, I should show you very quickly. I'm going to show you very quickly what kind of death we're in for, and in the next episode we'll avert that death. As you touch the sticky web, a giant spider drops down from her lair in the tree above. You attempt to escape, but her sticky web holds you fast. And she promptly kills you. So, we're going to avert that in the next episode, and I shall see you there. Thank you very much for watching.